we'll ask each singer to sing their aria, their nominated piece first once through, and then we'll come back and talk about it and hopefully work on it and come up with some alternative ideas and thoughts for them. So please welcome Kristin first, who's going to sing us a Handel aria.
Brad and I will perform Zenobia's aria, also known as Già che morir non posso, by Handel from the opera Radamisto. Just to give you hints of what's happening, I'm Zenobia, my husband is Radamisto, and his sister is the wife of Armenia's king Tiridate. The king is in love with me, he wants me to marry him, and he wants my husband to give me to him, no matter what, otherwise there is a war. And Zenobia asks her husband Radamisto to kill her, to stab her and throw her in the river and run away. He does so to save the whole nation, but Tridate's soldiers come and rescue her, so she doesn't die. And she sings very angrily to the Furies, saying, "Even this you don't think I deserve it?"
Accompagnatemi
Thanks, Christine. Shall we? Yes, a unified of salt, I think, is a good idea. Maybe, do you want to go on that side and I'll stay on this side? So, thank you. Well, first cab off the rank, you get the full load. So, so a couple of things. I would like to see more preparation of what you are going to sing in the bars before you start singing.
Okay.
I don't see very much of Fourier coming in the introduction.
Okay.
So I'd like to see a bit more of that. Now, Nicole's going to work on the language in a moment, but where are these furies?
Some of them in my mind.
Yeah.
And
but if you're on stage, let's say,
around me.
Yeah, abisso, where would that tend to be?
Here.
Down. Down, yeah.
Okay.
So that's something else that is going to apply to a lot of other people. Hand gestures that don't mean anything are not something that I like very much. So when you're, this kind of, you know, furia doesn't mean much to me because we're talking about furies from the abyss.
Mm.
So to me, it would be furia, and you draw them up from below. So we see this fire coming from underneath, because that's where the abyss is. They're not up here. They're not from heaven, so they're bad things, because traditionally in the Baroque, anything down there is bad, everything up there is good.
Yeah.
Just the same as right is good, left is bad, but that's another chapter. So, and I think also I would like to hear more sound on the furie. I'd like to actually hear more core in the sound. Now, I know that's hard when you've got a plosive furia, and it's a short note anyway. But I think we're just missing a bit of fullness of sound in there.
So you basically don't want an arrow of furia, you just want like...
Well, I want both.
Okay.
And Nicole, how do we do that?
I think I can help you.
Sure.
Can you speak this first line for me and connect the first part of the phrase to furia? So, già che morir non posso furia.
Yep.
Don't break. I heard... I would love a little bit more legato because I heard a little bit too... I know you are angry. Yes, you are very angry.
Mm-hmm.
And you want to, you know, really destroy. Some you want to summon the furies from hell to destroy him. Tiridate, right?
Yep.
So for me to do that, you need really beautiful legato and you have to sing every vowel. And I think if you can speak this first phrase as one, and
yep.
then take the rests as more like lifts.
Mm.
Not, già che morir non posso furia del, yeah? Già che morir non posso furia del cieco abisso.
Yep.
And not abisso, abisso. Keep the,
okay.
Yes?
Okay. So, già che morir non posso furia del cieco abisso.
Can we try a little bit more energy even in the speaking?
Yeah.
So can we go, I hear very polite.
Hmm.
No.
I think we need to get a bit more sense of would you mind just playing the sort of first couple of bars of the intro? A bit more of what you hear in the accompaniment being that we see that in you, this agitato thing. We're not really getting that at the moment. It's all very controlled.
Yeah.
We need a bit more. We need to see in your face, you, these furies, I'm going to get on these furies. I'm going to get them. And they're going
to
help me.
Sing or talk?
Yeah.
Is that okay, Grant?
But yes, can we just hear them? You're drawing up the furies from the abyss.
Okay.
That's what he's doing instrumentally, and we need to see you thinking that and thinking, yes, that's what I'm going to pull them up from the underworld.
Okay.
Mm. What does it mean, già che morir non posso? Can you give me word for word?
Even death is not possible.
Even già che
morir, I know is death.
To die, non posso. What does that mean?
Not possible.
I can't. Mm. Since I cannot die, because you say this because you have tried to die.
Mm.
And you tried to die and then they came to rescue you, you couldn't die.
Yeah.
So you are angry.
Yeah.
Idiots, they didn't get anything right.
Yes. Yes. So, and you can hear this in the music. You want to destroy them for what they have caused, but also, like Graham said, try. Just speaking.
Già che morir non posso.
Can I have everyone? So not già che morir non. Già che morir non posso.
Già che morir non posso.
Beautiful. Where's your posture too when you do this? Yeah.
How about you try this?
There.
Già che morir non posso. Fuori. And then open up. You do a lot of this, which all of them do, and we will see that coming up. That doesn't really. Sorry, but it doesn't really mean anything.
Yep.
So if you think of. And that intensity, that really almost hissing sort of.
Yeah,
but more specific. Do the hand turn on furia. Okay. Give yourself an accent on furia.
Ah, very good. Now, can you do this and not close the vowels? Già che morir non posso, non posso, food. And then what was it? Food, this one. Okay. So, non posso. Try.
Già che morir non posso, furie del cieco abisso, accompagnatemi.
Yep. Now, just one more thing. This is just me, it's just my idea. You can go out the door afterwards and think, that was a load of rubbish, I'm not doing that ever again. But I think it's important, because of the music, the way Handel has written it, we need to see a sudden twang, not a gentle opening up like this. I want you. But it's got to be that sudden change. Dun, 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 dun. Yep, it's exactly what's in the score.
Già che morir non posso, furia del cieco abisso, accompagnato.
Yeah. And now we get it in the voice. Now we hear what we need to hear in the way you're speaking it. And I think we'll get it when you sing it.
This is really good.
Yeah.
Beautiful. When you do just a little thing on double consonants, there's one here, accompagnatemi. Careful when you're angry, it's really easy to do. It's too much. Give me a little bit more vowel. So, we still have the double, but we don't close the vowel off to do a double. We don't do
accompa. And that's always hardest.
It's hard. Yeah. It's really hard. I can talk to you later about it, but I think we need more vowel to do this kind of thing. I still have double. Accompagnatemi nel mio dolor. Am I right? Yes, nel mio dolor.
Accompagnatemi nel mio dolor.
Never mio dolor.
Mio dolor.
Oh, beautiful. Watch where I put my roll on the end of that word, dolor. Mio dolor.
Mio dolor.
Yes. Do you think that's enough for now?
Yes. I think we should hear some singing now.
Già che morir non posso, fuori del cieco abisso, accompagnatemi nel mio dolor, accompagnatemi nel mio dolor, accompagnatemi nel mio dolor.
Right, what a difference. I think so anyway.
Very good, it's beautiful.
Yeah, it's great. And it's just got so much more energy and focus now. And that's what we need to see, because she's angry.
And now it makes sense why the piano is playing with me the same notes on the right hand. And
Yeah. Gesture-wise, just be careful. You've got a long ways to go yet. We're only at the beginning of the hour, and you've got to go through the whole B section. So just be careful of doing too much of all of this kind of stuff, you know, up around here at the moment, because that's like a... Steigerung. It's like a in English, it builds, you know. Okay. So you build up to sort of big gestures like that. So don't be afraid of keeping it low and dark and talking about the fool, yeah, and the what at the moment, you know. And it can even be this sort of da 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 da. So they're all swirling around your feet, and then maybe, you know, when you get to, sorry.
That's beautiful. I love this.
Well, you know, like serpents, yeah, and stuff. You know, the underworld, yeah, and all of that sort of horrid stuff that. There was a Harry Potter on last night. It was just ridiculous. But anyway, that sort of thing.
Yeah, there's a dragon thing.
Yeah, 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 and all of that. Because then you get the thing about mio dolor and mon cœur, mio cor, and all of that stuff. So save some of that stuff for a bit later.
Can I just try one thing? Già che morir non posso, fu. Can you not break? Can you just as an exercise? Già che morir non posso, fu. Can you hear what I'm doing between posso, fu? I'm not doing this. Posso, furie.
Yeah.
Can we try that?
Yeah, sure.
Furie del cieco abisso. Connect, go.
Okay.
And never stop. It's always with the, okay, with the air, with the breath. It has to keep moving.
Okay.
Can we try?
Yeah.
No break. Just try. Even if you stop after, not a problem.
Yeah.
We try. Okay.
Okay, just a little bit more accent. It was great, but just a little bit more accent on furia when you get there this time.
This one with the gesture.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
We're getting so much more sound. It's
so much easier.
Good. Well, that's a good thing. No, it's great because we're getting a much greater sense of the text as to what you're singing about and why you're singing it. And we're getting much more beautiful sound coming out. We're getting a stream of sound, whereas before it was, and we're getting much more of what I was after with that furia rather than the furia. There's a get more sound, core sound in that. Shall we go to the B section, I think,
yes,
because we want
any
to.
Any thoughts from the audience here?
Yes.
Any? Did you notice something?
All of you agree
there
with absolutely everything I'm saying and have no comments or criticism or no, I see, right, okay.
Actually, I have a question.
Yes.
With the Giacomo Rinomposo, there is a pause, like, I have
yeah,
a rest.
So I understand this.
With the fire going on?
I would love you to observe this, the rest, but it has to be in that line that you just did now.
Yeah.
So the line will go, but it's silent.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. And can you do that without breathing? Can you observe the rest but don't breathe?
Yeah.
Because that's the other, particularly when we get into recitative, that's the other important thing, that just because there's a rest notated doesn't mean you stop or you breathe. You can ignore, in this repertoire particularly, of course, you can ignore the rests completely and go with the flow of the language, or you can observe the rest but not breathe. That's a form of articulation which you need to use and take advantage of, particularly when you're singing this earlier repertoire, that gives you more tools in your toolbox, basically. Should we do this? Sorry?
B section?
B section, yes. Okay, so just tell me what this means. I'm sorry I'm putting you on the spot, I know, but what does this actually mean?
All I know from the melody,
yeah,
is that we're getting internal and we're getting,
yes,
into the pain she's feeling.
Yes.
Like her dignity is going to go on,
yes,
the feet.
Yeah.
And I know that non vibrato is like, kind of Handel is telling me, here it is, non vibrato please.
Yeah, sure, good. Can we, that's all right, that's fine. Can you try doing that without any of this at the,
sure,
moment?
Sure.
That's fine. I mean, just like this, if you like, for now, or this, but
okay,
without, just try. Imagine now that all this summoning up of all these, you know, horrible creatures did actually work.
Mm.
And they're all actually, well, there they all are there. They're all around. Yep. They've done what you wanted them to do.
Okay.
So when you sing to them, yeah, you can put it down there if you want to, but...
We go over the Italian, so it's really beautiful. I love what you sing. It's really, it's beautiful. There are a few things in the Italian we have to fix. Can you say for me, meco?
Meco.
Say for me the phrase, meco.
Meco, voi siate unite.
So, in a word like voi, we have to sing, even if it's the stress is on voi, we still have to sing e. I'm missing it. So, voi.
Voi.
Yeah. Stress is on the voi, but we still sing this vowel. So, and say for me, E a tormentar. Yeah, this is missing a little bit. Say the whole thing for me, and there's one word at the end I would like to. So, meco voi siate unite. Unite, stay on.
Unite.
I hear, even when you sing, unite, and I hear the vowel disappear.
Actually, unite is a bit tricky because there is a meco voi siate, teu is on one note.
Yeah.
And then unite.
You can do. Yeah, you're going to sing meco voi siate unite, teu,
okay.
Yeah? And then what I want is te unite, sing the last one.
Okay.
Yeah, then say for me this first part.
Meco voi siate unite.
Now, this is correct, but voi is quick, but I still want, so meco voi siate.
Meco voi siate unite.
Unite.
Meco voi siate unite.
Now be careful, the next one is very quick, but two vowels. Ea.
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 Meco voi siate unite. Unite.
So this, you can fix this later, but we have the, you finish with unite, same vowel starts the next one. E, close D. Eato. Very good, beautiful. Yeah, and then so, and then you rhyme. E a tormentar venite. It's a rhyme. Try this one.
E a tormentar venite.
This is correct. Now, what's this next word? It's a very strong word.
I don't remember.
Lempio.
Lempio tiranno.
Yeah, we can do more N. Lempio tiranno.
Lempio tiranno.
Can I have this M but less P? So not this, lempio. Can I have lempio, little P, but okay, lempio tiranno.
Lempio tiranno.
And not no, lempio tiranno di questo cor.
Lempio tiranno di questo cor.
Oh, that's very good.
So the train should go.
Always, always. Yeah, fantastic.
Okay, what? Try singing it. Really need to lean on those G flats. Because harmonically it's word painting. It's what he's doing.
Okay. So same place?
Yes, why not? Yeah.
An Italian was
what are you singing in this section? What are you saying?
I'm thinking like if I was Mozart's contest, I'll be sitting in front of the mirror and just feel like talking with myself.
Yeah,
so I'm thinking maybe if I'm in front of the river and it feels like, get me out of here, take me down.
Although you're talking to, this is fine, it's good. What are the words? Tell me what you said before is internal. Yeah, short, change colors are fantastic. What are the words though? So meco, come with me.
Come with me and help me in my tragedy.
Yes, if you have a look at the words, it's very strong. So, meco voi siate unite, you're saying, come be united with
me.
Yeah, to do what?
To torment,
come to do what?
The king.
Yeah. What do you want to do to the king?
Revenge.
Yes. What kind of revenge?
I just want to save my husband and my dignity. First
yes,
of all.
Okay.
Yeah, but you want to tear his heart out.
Yeah.
Basically.
You want to destroy
him. It's not just any
him.
Kind of revenge, you
okay.
know. This is graphic stuff.
Yes.
And it's really important to remember in this period, in earlier Mozart as well, and in other repertoire, that the period that it's set in, these people believed in the gods. And destiny and fate was determined by gods, not by you. And this is a prime example of that.
Okay.
You know, you were being, well, they were going to force you to marry someone you didn't want to marry. That's the gods intervening and telling you what to do. Then you got saved because those bloody idiots didn't know that they were told, let her drown. Someone said, oh, she's drowning, we better save her. So it's all the gods intervening. So you're railing against what the gods are forcing you to do and the destiny that they have determined for you. So this is kind of, I mean, we talked a little bit in the workshop, but this is really important for singers to understand the historical context of what they're singing, when it was written, what was happening in the world around that time. And the piece like this that's set in the period that it is, you need to think, okay, they believed in the gods. They thought they didn't have any say over their destiny. It was all predetermined and what happened to them. So there are people, characters like this who rally against that and say, no, this is not fair. This is not right, you know. I mean, think of Coronation of Poppaea when Ottavia is forced to leave Rome and it's addio Roma. You know, it's a prime example of destiny determining she is being kicked out. Poppaea, the little tramp, has taken her place. He's too stupid to realise what he's losing and what he's doing, but she's got no way of fighting it. It's not just the law, it's the gods determining it. And this is really important to get that other underlying sort of subtext thing about why she's singing this aria.
Okay.
That's time. Okay, just one more time of the B section. Okay, so not now, we don't have time. I would suggest you put a cadenza at the end of that B section, because it's very hard to do anything much at the end of the A section.
Yep.
You could do a bit, but I think you could play with the colour that is introduced there, with the sort of slightly minor key and the fact that it's, you know, Olympia or core and blah. So think of some of a nice little sort of cadenza that you can do there. But thank you, it's great,
thank
it's
you.
Really good.
Thank you.